10 tonight, Governor Perry and other state leaders are calling for a new law enforcement surge along the Texas-Mexico border.
The governor, Lieutenant Governor David Dewhurst, and Speaker Joe Strauss have told the DPS to take immediate action on the border. The goal, combating the large numbers of people entering the U.S. illegally. The state leaders have authorized the DPS to spend an additional $1.3 million each week. Lieutenant Governor Dewhurst releasing a statement saying the federal government has abdicated its responsibility to secure and protect the border of this country from consequences of illegal immigration. But as Texans, we know how to lead in areas where Washington has failed. The leaders say state lawmakers will need to address how Texas paid for all of the border protection during this coming legislative session. Yesterday, KXAN's Lindsey Bramson reported on the demands by some state lawmakers for Texas to step up its border security. You can find that story right now at KXAN.com. Next week, Congressman Michael McCaul will hold a hearing regarding the increased number of unaccompanied minors crossing the Texas-Mexico border. McCaul says the 60,000 or so children that came into the U.S. in the last year were drawn by failed U.S. border policies.
For the first time, journalists were given access to two U.S. border processing facilities that have been handling those tens of thousands of children. In Brownsville, Texas, about 500 children are being housed by the U.S. Customs and Border Protection Agency at Fort Brown. The center is less than half a mile from the international bridge over the Rio Grande. Some young boys and girls are sleeping on the concrete floor on Red Cross blankets or mats inside of holding cells. In Nogales, Arizona, a similar situation with holding cells turned into makeshift dorm rooms with cots. Right now, the center holds 840 children from Honduras, El Salvador, and Guatemala. Putting all of this into perspective, securing the border has taken on a new look since 2006, helping the Border Patrol out National Guard troops from around the country. If you remember, it was a spike of violence and undocumented people coming to the U.S. illegally. That's when President George W. Bush ordered 6,000 troops to the southern border. In 2010, President Obama reactivated the Guard's mission. That led to the well-known meeting with Governor Rick Perry, surprising the president with a personal letter requesting better protections for Texas. Since that time, there has been an ebb and flow to the number of troops as needed at the border. But right now, about 300 Guard members work along the border, and they are assisting the Border Patrol with aerial surveillance. However, the Army is facing budget cuts that could take away from air support from the National Guard. That means the assistance along the border could also be taken away.